with the new leadership in place for the foremost trade organization in Nigeria, the Nigerian British Chamber of Commerce, led by President Prince Adedapo Adelegun. It was an opportunity to engage the media on his plans and strategies for the year 2016 and what he will focus on. Prince Adedapo Adelegun speaks on the focus areas for the NBCC for the year 2016.
Well, in 2016, we have some key priorities. One is to advance, if possible, complete plaza that we're building. Secondly, is the sectorization of our membership into oil and gas, professional service groups, media, creative industry and tourism. We want to launch our Export Nigeria Club, that will be value chain for purchase in the export agricultural value chain. And then on Monday, by His Grace, we are going to be launching our construction and real estate group, doing a policy dialogue with the Honourable Minister of Housing, Works and Power. We also have two trade missions in view, one in June and one at the fourth quarter of 2016. The focus will be opportunity in Nigeria in terms of investment in agriculture, in mining, and partnership and in line with the government's aspiration. And then looking at also export of Nigeria products, which we call Made in Nigeria. We're working with Nigeria Export Promotion Council and Nigeria Investment Council to make sure that these trade missions are successful. In the course of the year, you know, every month we have a breakfast meeting. We intend to extend that to Abuja in the course of this year from the second quarter, by His Grace. And then our members' evening is already getting richer in terms of engagement of our members. And we will inaugurate our MBCC Academy, SME Center. We already have the premises in Yaba for that. That will be an incubation space for our SMEs and consulting in terms of, you know, market access services, legal accounting services, so that we can help assist them with services that will help them to grow. And we're partnering with a couple of SME sections, one or two banks, we're one of our premium members, to make this happen.
With the challenging face of Nigerian economy, dwindling crude oil reserves, and the fact that we need to divest the economy, how positioned is MBCC to help in this area in terms of what sectors you're going to look at and how to drive the economy contribution?
Yeah, like I said, our focus, like I said, is the sectorization of our membership. And through the sectorization, you provide a platform of interaction for people in the value chain of that sector. So oil and gas, for example, it's a huge industry, a lot of opportunities that Nigerians are not even aware of. And by bringing in the big companies who are members of the chamber to interact with SMEs, with other companies that are interested in the value chain, you begin to expand the opportunities, isn't it? And they can share knowledge, they can empower, capacity building programs can be enabled, trading can be enabled, and to the extent that for those of the bigger companies that are members or partners of the chamber, this capacitation and this exposure of opportunity to oil and gas industry will assist a lot of SMEs to take advantage in that area. Take the Export Nigeria Club, for example. The drive is to increase the annual export of Nigerian good foods into Europe and America and England by about 100% in the next 4 or 5 years, and also to attract investment in agriculture and mining. And so that's platform, for example, we bring the big players in the agricultural sector, with logistics companies, clearing agents, financial institutions, farmers, exporters, and also the importers on the other side to interact on a regular basis and speak to the challenges and also affect government policies that are inimical to the advancement of this generation of non-oil export revenue. So in essence, our vision is to assist each of the sectors, you know, to be galvanized and to bring, you know, higher, large organizations and SMEs all in the same room. Because in reality, SMEs, for example, cannot function or thrive without relationship and association with large corporations. For every Unilever or Cadbury or Shell, there are hundreds of SMEs that are servicing them. So it is this platform that will enable that interaction, you know, and the precondition is that you must be a member of the chamber.